Yes, Anushka. You can tell us about ballots now.
Yes, sir. I found two ballad poems by William Shakespeare. One is Come Away, Death. It is about a man who died because of his love, and when the lady whom he loved knew about it, she also died for some reason. And then the other one I found is The Phoenix and the Turtle. It is also by William Shakespeare, and it is about death and a funeral about two birds who got who died because of their love only. And about the meaning of Percival, sir, it says that he was some knight of King Arthur, and about his the way he fought in the war, something like that. It is given.
Okay. I'm opening here. 10 of the best ballads in English literature. While searching for all this, you must also have seen this website. Bonnie Barbara Allen, Sir Patrick Spence, The Unquiet Grave. And if you remember, there was one in class 9th also. Do you remember?
No, sir.
Sir, that of the lady.
The ballad in class. It was about a lady
yes,
who
sir.
Denied to give some cakes to a holy man.
What was that?
But that was a legend. No, but that was a legend.
I also very faintly remember there was something, there was some story in that. Does somebody
when
remember
some
the
saint
title
came
of
to
that?
Her shop and she was.
Was do you remember the title? Legend of Northland. Okay, yes. So legends are also stories. The thing is, legends are such stories which we've heard from others, which are passed on from one to another, and they do not have any authentic testimony, any authentic proof that yes, the story really, or whatever has been told in the story really happened. We don't know that. So something that appears to be an untrue story, just a told story, narrated story, passed on story, is legend. And in ballad, what we are talking about is stories in song. Now, when we say that was legend, but if that legend is told in the form of a song, then again it's a ballad. Are you getting it, Anushka?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है.
I also found some of the, I found 5 ballads in its title. So can I tell?
Just a minute, beta.
Okay.
I'm coming back. Just a second. हाँ बेटा बोलो. Who was talking?
Sameer.
Yes.
Sir, first one is As You Came from the Holy Land. It is by Sir Walter Raleigh. And second one is No, sorry. The first one summary is As You Come From the Holy Land is a brief poem attributed to Sir Walter Raleigh. Like most of the Raleigh's poetries, it serves as a tribute and complaint to Queen Elizabeth I, who, like a
Okay.
queen, like a man did aspire. The poem shares Raleigh's recurrent theme of a suitor abandoned by his love. In this case, his love is ventured on a pilgrimage and no longer loves him for he is old. So the second one is Ballad of the Gibbet. It is by Francois Villon. Third one is The Second Coming. It is by William Butler Yeats. The fourth one is The Ballad of a Bachelor by Ellis Parker Butler. And the fifth one is The Ballad of the American War. The Ballad on the American War. It was by Robert Burns.
Okay. Now, when you see some ballads, when you see the summary of the story that is told in ballads, and when you talked about few, and when we have just discussed about a legend, as I said, legend also is a story, and if it is in the form of song, it may be considered as ballad. When you particularly talk about ballad, what speciality do you see in it? First thing is it is sing song. Okay, it is a sing song, most important thing. Because ballads were written, composed for the purpose of being performed, especially in older times in front in the courts. In front of the emperors or the kings or whatever you call them. So it was composed to be performed, and the purpose of whatever performance was done in the form of dance. So that needs to be musical, that needs to be presentable in the form of dance. And when you're presenting something, it can never be anything negative. ठीक है, इट कांट बी अ नेगेटिव थिंग, इट कैन ओनली बी समथिंग वेरी पॉजिटिव अबाउट द पर्सन यू आर परफॉर्मिंग फॉर एंड स्पेशली इन फ्रंट ऑफ हिम. बट यस, इफ यू आर परफॉर्मिंग अ बैलेड इन फ्रंट ऑफ अ किंग हु हैज रिसेंटली डिफीटेड अनदर किंग फ्रॉम सम अनदर किंगडम, सो इन दैट बैलेड यू कैन compose it for the purpose of, for the sake of defamation of that king also, who has been defeated by your king. Quite satirical. Okay. So that sarcasm should be on the enemy. Then fine. So there was always a purpose. When in the earlier times, these things were composed. And when we see some examples here, as you just mentioned, and I can see also Sir Patrick Spence, that talks about somebody, then Bonnie Barbara Allen, Unquiet Grave. That sounds interesting. Unquiet Grave. I'll do as much for my true love as any young man may. I'll sit and mourn all at her grave for a 12 month and a day. This is part ballad, part ghost story, as you find a dead woman speaking from beyond the grave, telling her bereft lover to stop pining for her. Chalo. The Ballad of Chevy Chase. The Twa Corbies, Mary Hamilton, the Bonnie Earl of Murray, the Knight and Shepherd's Daughter, Get Up and Bar the Door, these are some famous ones, as the website says. So fine. And what was the other thing I asked you to find out about?
The meaning of Percival.
Before Percival, parody. So did somebody find?
Yes, sir, I found out something.
Tell me.
Yes, sir. Sir, parody is an limitation of style or a particular writer, artist or genre which deliberate exaggeration for comic effect.
Okay. In some Indian Hindi movies also you would have seen, now they do not do that, but in earlier movies, if you see older ones, you will find few famous songs were represented after making some changes in them, after changing the wordings, after changing some lines, and that means quite comically. It becomes very humorous. Something that was earlier composed and was appreciated, was liked, was one thing, was something serious. But in parody, what they do is they take that composition and then make some changes in that, rewrite it and make it humorous. Okay. And in that funny way, they represent it. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now I'm reading from here. A parody, also called a spoof, a send-up, a take-off, a lampoon. Itne sare terms use kiye hain iske liye. A play on something, a caricature or a joke, is a work which is created to imitate. Something is already there and you simply imitate that and make fun of or comment on an original work, its subject, author, style or some other target by means of satiric or ironic imitation. I hope you understood. Baki, if you open Wikipedia, you will find a lot. And you will find many videos of parody. And from literature also, you will find so many examples of parody. All is there, all available. Okay. Now, what was the third thing? Percival.
Meaning of Percival.
Okay. That's a name actually. Okay. So it represents somebody who was quite courageous, strong, general, you can say, fighter, you can say, knight, you can say, a commander, you can say. ठीक है, तो a famous for his famous knight or famous commander general for his bravery, for his courage. So such a name, if you call somebody else, that is metaphorical use. If you call somebody by somebody else's name, then it is metaphor. Okay? That's it. Anything else from the poem? Anything else that anyone wants to ask or discuss? Or else we can move on to the next lesson.
Sir?
Yes.
So here it is written that Ink, Blink and Mustard called the dragon custard Percival rudely. So does that mean they called him
satirically.
That
yes, he was not and just to tease. If there is a tiny child in your class, okay, एंड यू स्टार्ट कॉलिंग हिम द ग्रेट खली. इफ यू नो द ग्रेट खली, बॉयज नो, प्रोबेबली यू डोंट नो. ठीक है, तो वाई आर यू कॉलिंग दैट चाइल्ड बाय दैट नेम विच इज एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट ऑफ हिज पर्सनैलिटी? जस्ट मेकिंग फन ऑफ दैट चाइल्ड. ठीक है ना, तो समटाइम्स वी गिव नेम्स, समटाइम्स वी कॉल द लीस्ट परफॉर्मिंग चाइल्ड आइंस्टीन. We start calling people by such name in friends, among friends. ठीक है, so that is just for the sake of making fun of that person and sometimes satirically. ठीक है, चलो. Anything else?
सर, सो यहाँ पे रूडली क्यों लिखा है?
ऑब्वियसली रूडली है ना, ऑब्वियसली रूडली है वो.
ओके,
वो उसको जल रहा है ना कि इसने कैसे कर दिया, मैंने कैसे नहीं किया, मुझसे कैसे नहीं हुआ, तो इसलिए वो रूडली तो बोलेगा.
और कुछ? ऑल क्लियर? इफ ऑल क्लियर दैट मीन्स नो डैंड्रफ लेफ्ट. चलो फिर आगे बढ़ते हैं. व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट लेसन?
द सर्मन एट
बनारस.
द सर्मन एट बनारस. ओके, क्या हुआ?
पता नहीं,
हमें लगा था ये क्या लिखा है, बनारस लिखा है.
ये बनारस है.
बनारस
ये बनारस है. हम लोगों ने जो जो इंग्लिश लिखने वाले या जो फॉरेन राइटर्स हैं या जो इंडियन साउथ इंडियन राइटर्स हैं जिन्होंने बहुत कुछ इंग्लिश में लिखा है, हम लोगों ने बहुत सारे नेम्स जो हैं हमारे, या तो मतलब पर्सनल नेम्स, ह्यूमन नेम्स या प्लेसेस के नेम्स, सबकी बहुत वाट लगाई है. लगाइए. अच्छा, अब ये तो मान लिया कि चलो फॉरेनर्स ने लगाई है या जो लोग उसको नहीं जानते उसके करेक्ट प्रोनंसिएशन को उन्होंने लगाई है, मान लिया. बट हम हिंदी नेम्स को हिंदी बोलने वालों ने भी वाट लगाई है. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
हिंदी नेम्स का हिंदी बोलने वालों ने ही कबाड़ा किया है, ऐसा भी हुआ है? अच्छा, अब ये बताओ कि ये बनारस क्या बनारस है?
वाराणसी.
तो कहाँ वाराणसी,
कहाँ बनारस?
ये उसी से हुआ है टूटते फूटते, जिसको आप जब हिंदी पढ़ते हो तो आपने अपभ्रंश अपभ्रंश शब्द पढ़े होंगे.
Yes, sir.
तो हम जो है किसी वर्ड को या किसी नेम को कहां से कहां तक पहुंचा सकते हैं, ये चाइनीज विस्पर से कम नहीं है. Do you play that?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
यस सर,
बस एग्जैक्टली वही होता है, आगे पहुंचते पहुंचते पास ऑन होते होते नेक्स्ट जनरेशन तक जाते 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 यमुना बिकम्स जमुना। Somebody is writing Patliputra became Patna. Tiruvananthapuram became Trivandrum. Tiruvananthapuram तो आज भी बोलने में प्रॉब्लम होती है। It appears like
tongue twister. केरला के कुछ कुछ जो है पुरम वगैरह तो उसमें बोलने में समझ ही नहीं आता क्या बोले।
ठीक है। हाँ प्रसाद बिकेम प्रसाद, वो तो कई कई जगह हम ज्यादा करेक्ट करने के चक्कर में उसको इनकरेक्ट कर देते हैं। राघोगढ़ बिकम राहोगढ़ अच्छा राघोगढ़ बिकेम राहोगढ़ वो तो बोलने में हो जाता है, ठीक है जो अनुष्का सजेस्टिंग। इसके अलावा राधोगढ़ भी हो गया है वो,
यस
घ और
धा भी हो गया
राघवगढ़।
हाँ राघवगढ़ से राघवगढ़, राघवगढ़ से वो राधोगढ़ भी हो गया और रावगढ़ भी हो गया और साडा वीकेंड सांडा। वी कैन स्पॉइल एनी नेम, वी कैन स्पॉइल एनी नेम, है ना, वी कैन किल द ब्यूटी ऑफ एनीथिंग विद आवर टंग। ठीक है सो फाइन, कमिंग बैक टू सरमन एट बनारस, नहीं शिवपुरी शिवपुरी ओनली, नथिंग हैज चेंज्ड।
कहने में तो लोग कुछ कह देते हैं ना उसे।
हाँ बोलते वक्त तो फिर सबका थोड़ा तो अलग अलग रहता है, एक्सेंट अलग होता है, कई लोगों का वो श और स के प्रोनंसिएशन में प्रॉब्लम होती है, लिमिटेशंस होती हैं, है ना भाई। श जो है वो जब हम बंगाल में जाते हैं तो वो ख हो जाता है ना, तो फिर वो रीजन जैसे जैसे चेंज होता है वैसे वैसे एक्सेंट भी चेंज हो जाता है, लिमिटेशंस होती हैं, सारे प्रोनाउंसिएशन हर रीजन में अवेलेबल नहीं होते, तो जो अवेलेबल प्रोनाउंसिएशन है वो उसके हिसाब से वो लोग फिर उसको प्रोनाउंस करना शुरू कर देते हैं। तो फाइन, ये एक ऐसा टॉपिक है जिसके ऊपर हम बहुत सारी बात करते जाएंगे विदाउट रीचिंग टू एनी कंक्लूजन। ठीक है तो लेट प्रोनाउंसिएशन बी व्हाट इट इज एंड लेट अस ट्राई टू प्रोनाउंस एवरीथिंग इन द बेस्ट करेक्ट वे एज फार एज पॉसिबल। अगर हमें पता है कि उसका करेक्ट प्रोनाउंसिएशन क्या हो सकता है या क्या है तो हमें कोशिश करनी चाहिए कि हम उसे सही तरीके से प्रोनाउंस करें। ठीक है बाकी ये वेरिएशंस आएंगे, बाद में भी आएंगे, ठीक है हमेशा रहेंगे। सो सरमन एट बनारस, माय क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज सरमन। What do you mean by sermon? Try करो, guess करो, तुक्का मारो। Lord Buddha spoke to his disciples at this place, Banaras.
Moral teaching.
This is what we are reading.
Moral teachings.
Okay, and Saurabh has written speech. Fine. तो अब लॉर्ड बुद्धा ने क्या, इफ ही टॉक्स टू हिज डिसाइपल्स, तो जो उन्होंने स्पीच दी होगी, जो कुछ उन्होंने बोला होगा वो क्या होगा, क्या चीज होगी, आप क्या बोलोगे अपनी लैंग्वेज। हाँ उपदेश दिया होगा, प्रीचिंग। एंड व्हाट इज उपदेश और व्हाट इज सर्मन, व्हेन अ गुरु, ठीक है, स्पीक्स टू हिज डिसाइपल्स विद द पर्पज ऑफ शोइंग देम द राइट पाथ, द राइटियस पाथ, द ट्रू कंडक्ट, then that is उपदेश। कुछ अच्छी सी बात बताते हैं, बताने की कोशिश करते हैं। ठीक है अब जीसस क्राइस्ट का सर्मन एट द माउंट, आपने अगर मूवी जीसस देखी होगी शायद उसमें या किसी और मूवी में है ना, फेमस बाइबल में अगर आप थोड़ा बहुत उसके बारे में कुछ पढ़ते हो कहीं देखते हो तो ये दैट्स फेमस सर्मन एट द माउंट जो उन्होंने एक माउंट पे बैठ के अपने डिसाइपल से बात की थी, जो कुछ उन्होंने बताया था, ऐसे ही हम लॉर्ड बुद्धा का सर्मन एट बनारस अभी पढ़ रहे हैं। लॉर्ड कृष्ण ने अपने एक ही डिसाइपल को एक उपदेश दिया था, क्या था वो?
भगवद्गीता।
भगवद्गीता पढ़ लो।
वो भी उपदेश था, उन्होंने उनको एक राइचियस पाथ और सूटेबल कंडक्ट सिखाया था। अब आज हम लोग उसको पढ़ते हैं, हम लोग उससे सीखने की कोशिश करते हैं, समझने की कोशिश करते हैं जितना समझ में आता है। वैसे ही लॉर्ड बुद्धा ने भी कुछ बताया है, हम उसको देखते हैं कि उन्होंने क्या बताया है। और आई वुड वॉन्ट कि somebody reads it and reads it slowly, clearly and loudly so that everybody can do it. हाँ, इन पार्ट्स थोड़ा थोड़ा करके एक एक पैराग्राफ करके सारे बच्चे अगर रीड करें तो दैट विल बी बेटर। सुनो, सुन के उसको समझने की कोशिश करो कि उसमें क्या कुछ है। ठीक है, चलो। यस बेटा, स्टार्ट करो।
यस सर। द सर्मन एट बनारस। बिफोर यू रीड एक्टिविटी, यूज अ डिक्शनरी और आस्क योर टीचर्स हेल्प एज यू डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस इन ग्रुप। फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज अ सर्मन? इज इट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अ लेक्चर और अ टॉक? कैन दिस वर्ड आल्सो बी यूज्ड इन अ नेगेटिव वे और एज अ जोक? As in my mother's sermon about getting my work done online. Second, find out the meaning of the words and phrases given in the box. Afflicted with, decomposed, desolation, lamentation, procure, be subjected to. Third, have you heard of the Sermon on the Mount? Who delivered it? Who do you think delivered a sermon at Banaras? Gautam Buddha, 563 BC to 483 BC, began life as a prince named Siddhartha Gautama in Northern India. At 12, he was sent away for schooling in the Hindu sacred scriptures and 4 years later, he returned home to marry a princess. They had a son and lived for 10 years as befitted royalty. At about the age of 25, the prince, heretofore shielded from the sufferings of the world while out hunting, chanced upon a sick man, then an aged man, then a funeral procession, and finally a monk beginning for alms.
Begging.
Begging for alms. These sights so moved him that he at once went out into the world to seek enlightenment concerning the sorrow he had witnessed. He wandered for 7 years and finally sat down under a peepal tree where he vowed to stay until enlightenment came. Enlightened after 7 days, he renamed the tree the Bodhi tree, that is, the tree of wisdom, and began to teach and share his new understanding. At the point, he became known as the Buddha, the awakened or the enlightened. The Buddha preached his first sermon at the city of Banaras, most holy of the different places on the river Gangas. That a sermon has been preserved and is given here. It reflects the Buddha's wisdom about one in this. kind of suffering.
Inscrutable.
Inscrutable kind of suffering. Kisa Gotami has
just a minute, wait. Beta, wait. That's enough from your side. So what have we seen in this first part?
Introduction of it. How was he and how he became after years.
The backdrop of this sermon, who delivered it and who was that person and how he attained this enlightenment, how he went on to the path of searching for the wisdom, how he attained that wisdom, what was the place where he attained that. There was a tree later on called Bodhi tree. Later on, this person, when he actually was enlightened, when his preachings, when his thoughts were appreciated, admired and followed by many, he was given this name Buddha, which means enlightened soul, awakened. So this is how Buddha became Buddha. And this is his first sermon we are talking about. And what he said there is what we are going to read in this lesson. So from here, Kisa Gotami, it starts. So it's a story rather. Okay. So I would ask somebody else to read it now. Who is reading? No one?
May I, sir?
So late? Out of a class of 44, it took a long time to one girl. Chalo, fine, beta, start reading.
Kisa Gotami had an only son and he died. In her grief, she carried the dead child to all her neighbors, asking them for medicine. And the people said, "She has lost her sense. The boy is dead." At length, Kisa Gotami met a man who replied to her request. "I cannot give this the medicine for the child, but I know a physician who can." And the girl said, "Pray tell me, sir, who is it?" And the man replied, "Go to Sakya Muni, the Buddha." Kisa Gotami repaired the Buddha.
Shalya Muni.
Sakya Muni.
My book says it is S-A-L.
Sir, in our book it is
S-A-L.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine.
Yes, sir.
No problem. If it is K in your book, then call it Shakya Muni.
Okay, sir.
Just a minute. Let me share my screen. Have I got a special book? Which is different from everybody else's. Kahan gaya? I lost it here. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
Chalo, no problem. Continue reading, beta.
Okay, sir. Kisa Gotami repaired to Buddha and cried, "Lord and Master, give me the medicine that will cure my boy." The Buddha answered, "I want a handful of mustard seed." And when the girl in her joy promised to procure it, Buddha added, "The mustard seed must be taken from a house where no one has lost a child, husband, parent or friend." Poor Kisa Gotami now went from house to house and people pitied her and said, "Here is mustard seed, take it." But when she asked, "Did a son or a daughter, a father or mother die in your family?" They answered her, "Alas, the living are few, but the dead are many. Do not remind of our deepest grief." And there was no house, but some beloved
one he had died in it with no
wait. Now onwards, somebody else will read. Have you understood this part of the story?
Yes, sir.
What is it? Kisa Gautami.
Yes, sir.
She had her son dead. She wanted her son to recover from that illness. She considered it illness. Okay. She wanted him to be back to life, revived, and tried best of her way. She tried to get some suitable medicine for the child. When she couldn't get, somebody suggested, advised her to go to Gautam Buddha. And when she goes there, he agrees. He agrees to bring her son, her child back to life. And for that, he puts a condition. What was the condition? Get a fist full of mustard seed. But it should be brought from a house, from a household, where nobody has yet died. Maybe son or daughter, maybe a parent or whoever. But no one has died. Get that fistful of mustard seeds from one such household. She searched, she looked, she asked for that. Everybody was ready to give her mustard seeds. But when she asked for this thing, she couldn't find. Rather, when she asked such a question, it was grieving others. It was hurting others. Chalo, next. Who will read now?
Me.
May I? Sir Anushka?
I heard a boy's voice also.
Sir Karthikeya.
Chalo. Wait, Anushka.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Kisa Gautami became weary and hopeless and sat down at the wayside watching the lights of the city as they flickered up and were extinguished again. At last, the darkness of the night reigned everywhere, and she considered the fate of men, that their lives flickered up and they were and are extinguished again. And she thought to herself, how selfish am I in my grief? That is common to all. Yet in this valley of desolation, there is a path that leads him to immortality who has surrendered all selfishness. The Buddha said, the life of mortals in this world is troubled and brief and combined with pain. For there is not any means by which those that have been born can avoid dying. After reaching old age, there is death of such a nature are living beings. As ripe fruits are early in danger of falling, so mortals when born are always in danger of death. As all earthen vessels made by potter and being broken, so is the life of mortals, both young and adult, both those who are fools and those who are wise. All fall into the power of death. All are subject to death. Of
just
those,
a minute, wait.
Yes, sir.
In this part, from here onwards, every single statement is as powerful as any quotation. You should underline every single line. You should write down every single line as a separate line. Can you see? Though these all lines are just parts of this paragraph, but if you take them separately, pick up anyone. As ripe fruits are early in danger of falling, so mortals when born are always in danger of death. Take this line separately. It can be used for an explanation. It itself is a quotation. Now take this line. As all earthen vessels made by the potter end in being broken, so is the life of mortals. Isn't it a beautiful statement? It can be written separately. Now this line. Both young and adult, both those who are fools and those who are wise, all fall into the power of death. All are subject to death. That is again a very important statement. Earlier also we saw many good things. This realization. What was the realization of Kisa Gautami? This is the realization. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
No, that is again important. That what was her realization? That how selfish am I in my grief? Death is common to all. Yet in this valley of desolation, there is a path that leads him to immortality who has surrendered all selfishness. Only those who have surrendered all their selfishness will be led to where? To the path of immortality. They will attain immortality. And what sort of immortality is that? It is, see, this is valley of desolation. Acha, it is given here on the right side. You can see. Now, this is the valley of desolation. Means every now and then, at every step, at every moment, you will find something or the other that may hurt you, that may make you unhappy. Okay? So, this is a world where this will happen. It is world full of sorrow. Ab isme, if you surrender all your selfishness, if you are not selfish anymore, if you stop thinking about yourself, and if you start thinking about everybody else, आपका जो thought है वो I से V पे चला गया. आपकी जो prayers हैं वो for me से for everyone हो गई. ठीक है, then you will attain that status. क्योंकि फिर आपको कोई भी चीज जो है वो डिसोल्यूशन जैसी लगेगी नहीं. नथिंग विल डिप्रेस यू, नथिंग विल डिसहार्टन यू, बिकॉज देन यू वोंट बी थिंकिंग अबाउट योरसेल्फ, बट यू विल बी थिंकिंग अबाउट एवरीवन, एंड यू आर कंसिडरिंग योरसेल्फ एज अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट होल, दैट एंटायर थिंग एंड ऑल आर पार्ट्स. गॉट इट ऑल
सर? बट अगर वी से एवरीवन नहीं तो आई से वी हो गया, तो फिर दूसरों की लाइफ में जो प्रॉब्लम्स होंगी उसको लेके भी फिर सोच के दुखी तो होगा ना.
बिल्कुल अच्छी बात है. अब आप अपने लिए दुखी नहीं हो रहे हो, अब आप दूसरों के लिए दुखी हो रहे हो. ठीक है, अब आप दूसरों के लिए दुखी हो रहे हो, फिर अब आप क्या कर रहे हो? जो गौतम बुद्ध ने किया था, दुखी लोगों को देखा उन्होंने, वो दुखी हुए, दुखी होके उन्होंने एक क्वेश्चन की सर्च के लिए वो बाहर निकल गए. क्वेश्चन क्या था, किसी को पता है? किस क्वेश्चन का आंसर वो सर्च करने के लिए निकल गए थे घर से? भाई दुखी लोगों को देख के क्या उनके दिमाग में? भाई सारे जितने भी तरह के उन्होंने दुख देखे थे, जैसे स्नेहा पूछ रही है कि अगर हम दूसरों को भी अपना समझने लग जाएंगे तो जो दूसरों को दुख होगा उससे भी हम दुखी होंगे डेफिनेटली, है ना? ठीक है, एग्जैक्टली यही तो हुआ था. गौतम बुद्धा को यही लगने लगा था कि क्यों है इतना दुख, जो लोग मर जाते हैं वो क्यों मर जाते हैं, जो दुखी है वो क्यों दुखी है, जिनको तकलीफ है उनको क्यों तकलीफ है. फिर जब वो उस क्वेश्चन के आंसर की सर्च में चले गए, एक टाइम आया जब उनको ये रियलाइजेशन हुआ, ये रियलाइजेशन हुआ कि दैट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ, यू कांट फ्ली अवे, यू कांट रन अवे फ्रॉम ऑल दैट, यू कांट एस्केप. तो इंस्टेड ऑफ एस्केपिंग, स्टार्ट एक्सेप्टिंग. Start accepting. जो मैसेज यहाँ पे कीसा गौतमी को उन्होंने दिया है वो यही है ना कि ये तो एक साइकिल है, और जो इसमें टेंडर लाइफ होती है वो, जैसे यहाँ पे कहीं पे आया था ना, राइप फ्रूट्स आर अर्ली इन डेंजर ऑफ फॉलिंग, है ना? तो अब जहां पे टेंडरनेस ज्यादा है वहां पे चांसेस और ज्यादा है. जहां पे स्ट्रेंथ ज्यादा है वहां पे चांसेस कम है, ठीक है। तो आपको अपने आप को मॉरली मेंटली स्ट्रांग बना के रखना पड़ेगा और ये चीजों को आप एक्सेप्ट करते जाओगे। व्हेन वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट लॉर्ड कृष्णाज उपदेश, वहां पे भी यही था कि ये तो होगा, जो आपको लग रहा है कि दूसरों का दुख है उसको भी आपको एक्सेप्ट करना पड़ेगा कि इफ दिस कैन नॉट बी अवॉइडेड देन इट हैज टू बी एक्सेप्टेड। अंडरस्टूड स्नेहा?
यस सर।
चलो तो लिटिल बिट इज रिमेनिंग, लेट अस फिनिश इट। अच्छा इट इज ऑलरेडी 2:46, वी आर ऑलरेडी लेट। कितना बचा है यहाँ से बच्चे पढ़ना है ना? ऑफ
दो पैराग्राफ
अनुष्का, जल्दी से फिनिश कर दे, जल्दी से। डिस्कशन हम बाद में करेंगे अगर जरूरत होगी तो।
सर मैं पढ़ूं?
ओके सर।
कोई भी जल्दी से फिनिश कर दो, बस टाइम हो चुका है ऑलरेडी।
ऑफ दोस हु ओवरकम बाय डेथ डिपार्ट फ्रॉम लाइफ, अ फादर कैन नॉट सेव हिज सन नॉर किन्समैन देयर रिलेशंस। मार्क, व्हाइल रिलेटिव्स आर लुकिंग ऑन एंड लेमेंटिंग डीपली, वन बाय वन mortals are carried off like an ox that is led to the slaughter. So the world is afflicted with death and decay. Therefore, the wise do not grieve, knowing the terms of the world. Not from weeping, nor from grieving will anyone.
बेटा अभी एक सेकंड, मैं आपको रोक रहा हूँ। ये जो अभी स्नेहा का क्वेश्चन था, ये उसका आंसर है। Therefore, the wise do not grieve, knowing the terms of the world. आपको टर्म्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड अगर मालूम है देन यू विल नॉट ग्रीव इफ यू आर वाइज। आपको ये पता है तो यू आर वाइज, ठीक है। आपको समझ आ चुका है कि दिस इज अ पार्ट, है ना, तो फिर आप उसके ऊपर दुखी नहीं होगे, यू विल नॉट ग्रीव। दिस इज द आंसर टू हर क्वेश्चन। यस बेटा कंटिन्यू रीडिंग एंड फिनिश इट।
नॉट फ्रॉम वीपिंग नॉर फ्रॉम ग्रीविंग विल एनीवन ऑब्टेन पीस ऑफ माइंड. On the contrary, his pain will be the greater and his body will suffer. He will make himself sick and pain, yet the dead are not saved by his lamentation. He who seeks peace should draw out the arrow of lamentation and complaint and grief. He who has drawn out the arrow and has become composed will obtain peace of mind. He who has overcome all the sorrow will become free and from free from sorrow and be blessed.
ठीक है, ये पूरे उसके उसके क्वेश्चन के आंसर्स पूरे इन दोनों पैराग्राफ्स में मिल गए हैं, ठीक है। चलो लेट अस क्लोज इट हियर, से सायरा एंड लीव द क्लास।
थैंक यू सर।
थैंक यू सर। थैंक
यू सर। सायरा सर।
सायरा।